Everyone, welcome to our channel LexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai, and in this particular video I'll be talking about data smoothing techniques. This is part 2 of time series analysis. If you haven't watched my part 1 video, then you can go ahead and click on the I icon on the top right hand side corner of your screen and you'll be directed to those videos. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. So data smoothing is done to better understand the hidden patterns in our data. In non-stationary process, it is very hard to forecast the data as the variance over a period of time changes, so that the data distribution actually over the period changes. Therefore, the data smoothing techniques are used to smooth out the irregular roughness to see a clearer signal. So in this particular video, I'll be talking about two of the most important data smoothing techniques, that is, number one, moving average smoothing, and the other is exponential smoothing. So when I talk about moving average smoothing, what it basically means is that it is a technique where the data is divided into subsets. The entire data is divided into subsets. And then the between subset values are found through this method. And then the trend is, then forecasted over a period of time. Now in this particular video, I'll be taking an example to explain you what is moving average smoothing and what is exponential smoothing. So let's first check out moving average smoothing. So here I have a data where I have first cell or column as quarters 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6, and we have the second cell, that is prices, and we don't know the value of sixth quarter here. Now if I plot this particular graph from this portion to this portion, I see a data visualization or a plot like this, where the data is moving in an irregular manner. So to smoothen out the data and find out the between quarter values of this particular data, what we are going to do is we are going to use moving average smoothing in this case, and the formula for the same is that so suppose you want to calculate the data of this particular column. This particular column here. So what you're going to do is, for this particular column, that is the sixth quarter, we will take few values or the past data over a period. We will take the past data, a subset of the data in particular, and then we will divide it by the number of values in that subset. So here, for taking out the value of this sixth quarter, what we are doing is we are going to take three values. It depends how many what should be the size of the window. Here I am taking three. You can even go for four if you have a larger data set, or five or six. It depends on your choice. So here I am taking three quarter data, and I am going to take the average of the three quarter only, so that I am able to predict this value or forecast this value with the help of this value, as the as these are the nearest values to this unknown. So here I have 18 taken from the third quarter, 14 taken from the fourth quarter, and 15 taken from the fifth quarter here, divided by the number of values we have taken, which gives us 15 here. So the value of sixth quarter is 15.7 that we have forecasted. Now same thing we are going to do for all the rest of the columns. Say if I want to find out the values between these quarters, this quarter and this as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this 10 value. One more thing is that the initial quarters, whatever, suppose that you want to take 3 data points to calculate the value for your fourth quarter. In that case, what you're going to do is since we do not have anything above these values will be fixed. 10, 11 and 18. And suppose you're taking an average on the basis of 2 quarters, in that case, these 2 values will be fixed, the initial 2 values. And then beyond that, you will be predicting the data or smoothening the data overall. So that you get the middle value between these 3 quarters and this value in particular. Okay, so here we have for mean average smoothing, we have 10. Again, taking the 3 quarters, 10, 11 and 18 divided by 3. And then we have 11, 18, 14 divided by 3. So 11, 18 and 14 divided by 3. So we get this value. So we are smoothing out the entire data itself and not only predicting this value, but smoothing out the entire data depending upon the number of quarters we are taking in. So once we are done with that, we get a data like this. So we have 10 MAS. For this we have 10, 11 and 18. So you see on the screen, after the previous calculation which was done here, where we calculated the value of 6th quarter and we also got the smoothed value of 4th and the 5th quarter by taking into consideration the first 3 quarters data, we got 15.7 for the 6th quarter, and for the 4th quarter we got 13 value, and for the 5th quarter we got 14.33. so once we got that value, what we can do is we can compare the graph, the visualization of the previous data, and we can also see the data for the smoothed technique. So here we have 10, 11, 18, 14, 15, and here we have 10, 11, 18, 13, 14.33, 15.7. So you see that in the previous form of data, the problem was that there was no identifying factor in the there was no trend in the data in particular. It was like that initially the data was moving was at the lower rate and then moved sporadically upwards and then again moved downwards, and that's that. Here what we see is that after taking the moving average of the data which was initially there, we could see that after a certain point we are seeing an upward sloping graph here. Right, so this is what moving average does. It takes out the trend where there is no trend in reality, so that we are able to get a clear picture of the data instead of having and we can put this particular data into any kind of functional form to forecast data. Even though this technique is also used as forecasting, you can see that we didn't have the sixth quarter data, but we were able to forecast it with the help of this moving average technique. Now the next in line is the exponential data smoothing, where suppose that we are using the same data which we were using previously, and what we are doing is we are taking these quarters here and we want to find out the value of the sixth quarter. Now exponential data smoothing technique requires the calculation of the entire sheet instead of this value, because if you look at the formula is EMA equals to FT. So if we want to calculate the data in a time period T, we need previous value of the data plus some constant value. So the exponential smoothing requires a constant value by which the data moves exponentially. So we get, this is also, this A is also called weights. Now after giving it a weight, what we do is we calculate the difference between the original value and the previous year's value. Okay, so for this particular thing, since we do not have the F column previous year's data for predictions, which we like in the previous set we use 3/4, here we will be using the F minus 1 for the initial quarter to be the same as the initial data. So here we have 10 and 10. Okay, after that we subtract that value, whatever the original value is, from that FT minus 1. So if you are calculating the value here, what we need to do is we need to go back, check for this value and some constant. Now what this constant should be depends upon, there is a rule in particular that suppose that as recent the value, the weight should be higher, and as the data moves distant, the weight also decreases exponentially. So this part alpha, in our particular example we'll be taking 0.5 because the data is not that moving in not that of a hump and bump, but the only outlier is this 18 value in particular, so that's why we are using 0.5. It can be any value between the weights, can be any value between 0 and 1, so it can be 0.1, 0.2 as the data so as the data is distant, then in that case the value will be closer to 0. In case the data is more of a recent one, then the value will move towards closer to the 1 value. So here we are using 0.5 as an exponential factor by which the data will increase. So let's go to the calculation part. Now what we are doing is, as I said, that for the previous data we need for 6th quarter value we need a data, we need to calculate the entire EMS value. So for that we are taking 10 value as our initial value, and here we have FT. So for quarter 2 here, suppose we do not have this value in particular, so what we can do is we will calculate this 10. We have FT minus 1, that is this value is 10, plus our alpha value multiplied by 10 minus 10, that is 80 minus 1. So 80 minus 1 originally is this value 10 here. 10 minus 10, that is FT minus 1 minus FT minus 1, and we get a result as 10. Now again we will do the same thing till 6th quarter. So here we have 10 again, that is the FT minus 1. Now we have 10 value here. We have 10 here, that is FT minus 1, because we want to now calculate this value. So for FT minus, again, for the value will be FT minus 1 is 10, because we are calculating this value. 10 plus 0.5, 0.5 is the alpha value, the weight by which we are increasing the data. And we have 11 minus 10, again the original 80 minus 1 minus the FT minus 1, that is the predicted value minus the observed value, equals to 10.5. and we'll move forward with again. Now next is that we don't know the value. Suppose we want to calculate this value, 10.5 is this one. We want to now we have this value and we want to calculate the value of this place. Okay, so what we are doing is, again we are using this FT minus 1, the previous year data, FT minus 1 which we have just predicted, plus 0.5, again the constant factor, 18 minus 10.5, that is 10.5, and 18 is the 80 minus 1 again, that is the previous year's data, equals to 14.25, and so on and so forth, and we get the end result. We get is that we get the value of the 6th quarter as well with the help of this initial data. So the movement is exponential, and here we can see that the original data, if we go here, the original data looked like this, and once we have calculated the exponential values, we get a graph like this, and we see that there is an upward moving trend, and then here we have also forecasted the value of sixth quarter as well. So this is what exponential moving average looks like. It converts the data into a form that is more explainable in reality, and the trend is, we are able to find the trend in the data when there is no trend in reality. You can use moving average as well as your exponential moving average method. Most generally people use exponential moving average as it gives more accurate result, but you can again use any of the two methods. So that's it for this video. Hope you like this video. If you did, then don't forget to click on the like button. Also subscribe us. And if you want to know more about DexLab Analytics, or you want to learn more from us directly, you can go ahead to the website www.dexlabanalytics.com and check out our brochure for deep learning analysis, time series analysis, natural language processing, and so on and so forth. We all teach that. And if you want to reach out to us via phone numbers, so you can just call us on these numbers. If you want to WhatsApp us, you have the WhatsApp contact numbers here. And if you want to mail us directly or reach out to us directly, you can also use hello@dexlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. Don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you're updated with the or notified when I upload my video. In my next video, I will be further explaining you the time series analysis and the techniques, how you calculate ARIMA, and what is ARIMA and what is ARAMA and all that stuff. Thank you for this video. Bye bye, take care.